Hello everyone, it's Sasi again, and I'm going to show you how to change a LCD screen. Here we have a Lenovo ThinkPad T61, and as you can see, it has some major screen damage. So not only is there a nice size crack right here, but there's also all these lines going on. And the image is all kind of goofy right there. This is supposed to be the BIOS. For this repair, you really don't need that much. With the ThinkPads, you pretty much just need a screwdriver and a little like X-Acto blade or a razor blade, so you could take out the stickers on the LCD. You could use a spudger. I don't have one, so I just use like a PC PC card spacer. And then if you want, you could put your screws away too. For the most part, you really don't have to take out that many screws. You get the on the hardware maintenance manual, you have to take out these screws. And also for the LCD, you're gonna have to take out these ones. And then there's also two screws inside there. Pretty much all these screws right here, the ones that you need to take out with the little pictures on there, they are all the same size, but when you come to this, a few of the LCD screws, they're a bit different size. So just know which one is which, unless you're gonna mess up your keyboard or your speaker bezel. This part is pretty straightforward. Just gotta take out the screws. I forgot to mention that all you really need is a Phillips screwdriver. You don't need like a specialized one or a flathead. Here comes the fun part, taking out the palm rest. These things are a pain sometimes. When you pull up, gotta take out the touchpad sensor. You pull back. Alright, it seemed like I forgot to pull out an extra screw there for the keyboard. So you won't see in the video of me taking that out. Next is the speakers. You got one screw right here. On the other side there isn't a screw, but that's because you take out the screw in the bottom. Next you got the screw for the fan. I believe you had, oh no, maybe not. Take out the Wi-Fi, what are these called? Strings. And then we also have one for we gotta take out the LCD ribbon cable. Might as well take this one out for the Wi-Fi card. Put that away. Okay, and now we have to take off this bezel right here. It's best to use a spudger to at least pry off this part. I wouldn't recommend a screwdriver because you could damage this part, these pieces right over here. So it's not best to use that. And we're gonna do the same thing on the other side. Next are the LCD screws. Or I should really say the hinges. Well, I guess one of them holds the speakers. Those two in the center hold the hinges, and the ones on the edges hold the speaker bezel. Oh, so I guess, thinking of the other model where screws are a bit different, these ones, they're different sizes. Okay, next, here you have some two hinges for the or two screws for the hinges, I should say. One on the left, one on the right, of course. So you get that one. I believe these are both the same size. Yep, they're right there. Take those bad boys out. Make sure you pull back this cord from right here. With the LCD cable. I guess the tape that goes with it. And pull it out. Alright, so next is the LCD. Alright, this is when the razor blade is going to come in handy. You have a screw here, screw there, and there. And with this model, there are no screws on the side. So we're looking on that. I think that was only on the T40 series. That this part is pretty straightforward. Oh my! Time for us to get the screws. I believe these are all the same size. Find out in 1 second. So far, so good. Oh, look, that one's a little bit different sized. So the screws on the bottom are the longer ones, while the ones on top are a little bit stubbier. All right, here comes the fun part about these things. They always seem to have some sort of a glue going on the screen. Yeah, they always stick tape or glue on these things, so they're always a pain in the ass to do. Personally, normally you wouldn't really care if you're replacing the screen, but if you want to add like Wi-Fi or Bluetooth, then you're gonna have to, take care on this part, because this is where it gets ugly. Sometimes you don't even need the spudger. Maybe you do. I think I'm breaking the contacts right now. You get the widescreen T61 is not fun to work with. I just don't want to come off. Jesus, this does not want to come off. Did I miss a screw? No. Oh, okay, so pull down at the same time. That's the trick. Of course, there's a glue one on this part on the bottom. Oh my god. I think I'm accidentally getting it the LCD screen. Oh, I'll probably could salvage the backlight from this. All right, let's see. Oh yeah, I broke those contacts. Yep. All right, the top part is fun. You can find out if it's glued or not. Don't feel like it's glued. There's glue right here. There's not. I don't know. The top part, you have to keep track of the latches. There you go, latches. They like to, you don't want to break those things off. Jesus. Oh, alright, so yes, it's best to get a spudger. Alrighty, and I pretty much knocked out all of the Oh no, those are good. Oh, this one's, that one's cracked. Maybe you can tell. Correct that one. Alright, so don't watch this video. This video is bad. This is a bad instructable. Alright, and this part, you have to take off all the screws on the hinges that hold the LCD. You got them all right here. And afterwards, when you take it out, there's going to be a little screw on the sides holding it also. There's also, you have to take out if you have Bluetooth, you got to take out the Bluetooth screw. You got to take off one for the inverter as well. And this part's, when you take off the LCD, it's tricky because the LCD ribbon cable likes to stick with it. So take out Bluetooth. I don't know if I could take off this part yet. No, I'm probably not. Probably best not to. I should be keeping track of the screws. But I think these are all the same. Minus the ones on the bottom. The ones on the for the Bluetooth and the inverter. Alright. And then next is lift this. Wait, make sure you pull out the think light. Pull this back. There you go. Now you just gotta take off, pry off this little piece. And also the inverter. There you go, here's the inverter. Alright, so just put something underneath the LCD so you can have an angle, because this is going to be pretty tough. And I'm handling this LCD pretty badly. I don't care. I mean, this thing's broken. But if I were to be replacing the backlight on this thing, I probably wouldn't be doing. Oh my gosh, I would handle this thing a lot more care. Jeez, this sucker's just in there. And I have to say that if you have a T400 or any sort of a 14-inch widescreen ThinkPad, for the most part, I know that the LCD screens, they're swappable. I swapped a T60 screen onto a T400 and it worked just fine. I sold that laptop and I haven't heard anything bad about it, at least, so. Sweet. Alrighty, now we got the hinges. Oh yeah. Another thing is that before you actually assemble the LCD screen on there, it's good to check to see if the screen's actually working or not. I have like a bunch of screens, because, oh great, awesome. Anyways, I have I collect quite a couple of these, and I have a bunch of excess parts. So sometimes I might put them in the wrong spot, or there I might have like a few of them that have like mess up little parts. But yeah, the screen's working good. It's the Windows 7, and let me see if I can get a better video of this. For the most part, it doesn't look like there's any kind of no dead pixels. Looks like I cleaned up that part right there. So we're good to go. Alright guys, so just do everything I did in the video, and then when it comes to assembling it back, just reverse it, just reverse the video, and it'll come out looking like this. Just kidding.